IDF say they shot dead the Catholic woman murdered in North Belfast. Mourners at a UFF victim's funeral hear there is no justification for murder. A Belfast judge warns of heavier jail sentences as long as terrorism continues. Good evening, this is UTV Live at 6 on Monday, January the 18th. So the upside.
Good morning, and now the news in UTV Live. A 46-year-old news agent.
The headlines on UTV Live at 6. The Ballymoney policeman was unarmed as a loyalist mob kicked him to death. George Mitchell meets Tony Blair to discuss tomorrow's Stormont talks. And an American firm brings 300 computer jobs to Belfast. Good evening, you're watching UTV Live at 6 on Monday, June the 2nd.
Belfast City Council has elected its first nationalist mayor. Alban McGuinness of the SDLP won by 26 votes to 22, drawing support from his own party, Sinn Féin and the Alliance. The multi-party talks resume tomorrow and Sinn Féin says it will be demanding entry. And it's emerged that the IUC officer kicked to death by a mob in Ballymoney at the weekend was not carrying his police revolver at the time.
Friday edition of UTV Live.
Good evening, the headlines.
There's fresh hope for the South Tyrone Hospital as a court hears a challenge against closure. And a drunk driver is jailed for 5 years for killing a 7-year-old boy from Belfast.
And also tonight, it's a big weekend for the two Eddies in the race for the Formula One world title. Adrian Logan is at the...
Good afternoon, now the local news. An Armagh father who lost his temper.
Good afternoon, the headlines on UTV Live this lunchtime.
The father of a Protestant schoolboy tries to attack the woman who's been charged with his son's murder. And riot police escort Catholic schoolgirls as residents change their protest tactics.
The father of the 16-year-old Belfast boy who died after being knocked.
Doctors say they are very pleased with George Best's progress after his operation.
No prosecutions over the spread of foot and mouth here.
And talks are held to ease clashes at Belfast interfaces.
And tonight we report from the village of Clonie in County Derry, where exactly 30 years ago today, 9 people were murdered in a series of no-warning bomb attacks. We reflect on the thoughts of one family devastated by that atrocity.
Doctors in London say they're very pleased with the progress George Best is making after his...
Good afternoon.
Hello and welcome. You're watching UTV Live.
Hi. Now, as you know...
Hello and welcome to UTV Live.
And a very happy new year to you from the whole team. We're back. Good morning and welcome to the news from UTV. A pharmaceutical company is creating...
Good morning and welcome to the news from UTV. Further tests are to be carried out this morning on a human...
With the Stormont talks on the brink of collapse, the two prime ministers fly in.
We believe that the problems that exist in devolving policing and justice are all soluble problems.
Sinn Féin and the DUP can't resolve their dispute over orange parades.
3 years on, we are waiting for the DUP to deliver and honour their commitments.
And straight to this evening's top story. The two prime ministers have flown in tonight. It's 10:30 on Wednesday, the 20th of January. You're watching UTV Live tonight. Good evening, I'm Paul Clark. Welcome to the programme. It's been revealed that the DUP and Ulster Unionists have...
Calls for the public to be alert as the number of swine flu cases doubles.
We're not in a pandemic situation. We have a vaccine which can prevent against it. We have treatment for it.
Pressure grows on Northern Ireland water. We ask, why couldn't we cope with the big thaw?
And prices go up as the VAT increase kicks in.
Hello and welcome to the programme this Tuesday evening. I'm Alison Fleming.
And I'm Mark Mallett. Thanks for your company. Also on UTV Live.
Deaths on the roads here fall to the lowest level ever recorded.
Back where it all began, former Cliftonville star Liam Boyce makes a festive return from Bundesliga giants Werder Bremen.
And there's a sense of dread when we mention snow. We will give a quick reference to it tonight, but how much will there be? Full details here in 25 minutes.
But before that, this evening's top story. There's been a major increase in the number of flu cases.